10th, rejection of the typical view of the central bank as independent. The central bank is sort of a guardian to make sure the government doesn't spend too much money and cause inflation. The central bank is not independent, and it is not potent. Okay. The monetary policy is a very weak tool. People think that you can just abandon fiscal policy and use monetary policy to fine-tune the economy. They cannot do it. People think the central bank can control inflation and reverse course when you have deflation, as you've had in Europe. That's false. They don't have the tool to do that. They cannot do that. We don't really even know if raising interest rates slows the economy or speeds it up. We don't know if lowering the interest rate to zero is going to stimulate the economy or cause it to continue to crash. Okay? I'll just put out there, and we can debate it later if you want. There is no empirical evidence to support this at all. There's no empirical evidence to support the belief that raising interest rates fights inflation. Okay? The correlation actually goes the other way. Raising rates is correlated with higher inflation. So what can the central bank do? It can't say no to the Treasury. So it actually does not have the tool to control government spending either. The central bank is the Treasury's bank. All payments are made through the central bank, and all payments to the government come through the central bank, but the central bank can't stop the government from spending, because it's never going to bounce a Treasury check. The Treasury sends out checks on the first of the month to all your retirees. The central bank is not going to bounce those checks when banks submit them for payment. So there's no way that the central bank is going to prevent spending. Now, they might raise interest rates, fearing that government spending is going to cause inflation, but as I already said, that might be inflationary anyway, too, and it can't prevent the government from spending. So we need to give up the idea that they're independent in any matter except for setting the overnight interest rate target. And maybe it's even a bad idea to let them do that, because they tend to do what the Fed just did: raise interest rates as we go into a recession. The timing is impeccable. You can tell whether we're going to go into a recession or not, because the Fed always starts raising rates when there's evidence we're heading toward recession. So impeccably wrong policy consistently. So we probably should take that away from them. So I'll stop with that 10th point.